All right. At the Strong Falls Trail System here in Marinette County, Wisconsin. About an hour north of Marinette, Menominee. Mostly cross-country type of trail system here. A lot of greens and blues. There is some black, about 2 miles worth of black stuff in the center that we'll get to. And it's about 13 miles here. Everything's labeled really well. There's a lot of, at every intersection there's a sign, and yeah, it's marked really well. Rock solid contracting worked on this. And from what I've heard is they plan on eventually making 50 miles worth of single track here. So I'm gonna be going counterclockwise. From what I understand, that's what most people do. This is like my third time out here, so. I'm gonna ride it all for you guys today. This is a shared trail for hiking and walking. Sometimes you'll catch some hikers out here. But for the most part, it's pretty empty. I'd say if you're into XC stuff, this would be a great place to check out. Something different. Trail's really shaded for those hot days too. It's not so bad. It's not really any jumps or, you know, crazy downhill, berm stuff, anything like that, but there is some pretty cool rock work. There is some nice flowy sections. So there's a nice marker like this at every intersection. And they put the star on there. This is where you're located. So it's really helpful. It's another green section. And then we're gonna get into some blue. Here's the section of blue. Thank you. no big climbs or any like sustained downhill, but like I said, there is some flowy sections. It's one of those trails, like, the more you put in, you can find a lot more spots of flow. There are some tight spots like that. Did a really good job of working with the natural features here. Pretty cool. And this is one of the hillier areas around here. Most of Wisconsin's pretty flat. Here's a weird little intersection. The black diamond stuff's up there. It's about 2 miles. You can also hop in from the top. I don't know if you can see that good. Okay, so we're right here. So we could also go stay on the blue and hop in at the top, but I'm gonna go around the whole thing and pop back out here. It's really easy to miss this. Yeah, let's check it out. I'll try to shift here. All right. Really helps out a lot once you get into this to try to carry speed, because there is some pretty crazy rock. Rock gardens, I guess. And I haven't done this enough to, you know, figure out if these are all one way or both, you know, directions. Maybe it's better to come down this than climb up it, but like I said earlier, I'm just trying to stick with clockwise. Weird little entrance. Definitely helps to do a little ratcheting on some of these. You can catch your pedal. I'm riding a 29er out here. I think it's being as flat as it is, and not many berms. I think that's the way to go. There's a little baby gap jump right there. Might be about it. There's a couple little rock ledge jumps to flat too, I guess. Ooh. Tried to make it up that a couple times. It's pretty steep. Let's go around it today. Some of these loops haven't even made it on Strava, but some of them are up there, shorter segments. Like that. It'd be pretty tough to keep your momentum. If you weren't cruising into that one, it'd be really hard to get through. I think this section's 1.3, and then the second section, which is coming up here, is 0.9 miles. So about 2 miles of this black, chunkier stuff. Thank you. know this won't be the most entertaining video I've ever made, but I'm hoping if, you know, anyone wants to come out here and they want to, the good with the bad, to see what it's like, then this will give you an accurate kind of picture of that. Instead of cutting out all the climbs and just showing you the goods. Here's the halfway point. So this is gonna bring us back down to where we started. If we would have went right back there, it would have kicked us out further down from where we came in. Since I'm trying to show you it all, then I'm gonna head back to where we came in. Some of this can get tricky. Kind of low speed and real chunky. Kind of throw you off balance. Intersections coming up here. There's a lot of ride arounds for any of the longer rock gardens and weirder rolls. Here's one of those too. As you can see, kind of a narrow little spot there. And then there's a drop. I always forget whether you can roll that or not. And you can't. This is where ratcheting really comes in handy. Branch in the way. Try her again. Alright, here's where we started. That's the black section. Pretty slow in tech. Flow, cool down a little bit. Stick in the spokes. Mm-hmm. a little bit of flow. That's the entrance to the double blacks right there. So we're about halfway. Maybe a little more. Uh-uh. go straight here. That is something that they're still working on, I believe. So as long as you keep going all right, you'll get out of here fine. Except for that one. Right. Like a little bog or something over that way. That's how you know we're getting close. Probably a couple miles left. If you're really moving and you don't take many breaks, you can get this done in an hour or so. Maybe an hour, 10 minutes. Again, hang right. Thank you. trailhead. Battery died, had to swap her out. I checked my phone. It says we're 10.6 miles in right now. So we're getting pretty close to the end. And there it is. Like I said, pretty much a cross-country type trail, but there's a lot of rock work going on. It's a good little ride. rock solid, did a good job with it. And Mamba, the Menominee Marinette Biking Association, they do a good job of the upkeep out here. So if you're in the area, come check it out. Thanks for watching.